Sunday. Yes. And this is the temporary material, which is the soul. And the other one is not marked, so we need to mark it. Which is, one second, we need to find this next one.
Ostem de nobis Domine misericordia tua. Domine exaudi orationem meam. Dominus vobis. Omnipotens eterne Deus, et emiter redigneri sanctum angelum tuum de celis, cui custodiat, foveat, protegat, visited et cui defendat omnes habitantes in hoc habitatum, per Christum Dominum nostrum. Thank you. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Laudamus Deo. Omnipotens sempiterne Deus, qui ab audientia pietatis tuam, et merita supplicum excedis et votam, et funde super nos misericordiam tuam, ut et imitas quae conscientiam etuit et adicias quod oratio non presumit. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Deus qui non mortem sed penitentiam desideras peccatorum, populum tuum ad terre vertentem propitius respicim, ut dum tibi devotus existit, racunti et tue flagella, ab eo clementer amoveas, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum Filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Apostle, qui non sunt in Deus vulgari apostoli,
dominus vobis. Sequentia sancti evangelii secundum Marcum. In illotem porem, exiens Iesus de finibus tiri, venit per sid donem ad Mari Galilei inter medios fines de Capoleus, et aducunt ei surdum et mutum, et deprecabuntur eum ut imponat illim alum. Et apprehendens eum de turbas eorsum misit digitos suos in auriculas eius, et expuens tetigit linguam eius, et suscibiens in celum ingenuit et ait illi, et feta quod est ad aperire. Et statim aperte sunt aures eius, et solutum est vinculum linguae eius, et loquebatur regetim, et percepit illis nequi diceret. Quanto autem eis precedicebat, tanto magis plus predicabant, et eo amplius admirabantur dicerent. Bene omnia fecit, et surdos fecit audire, et mutos loqui.
Dear brethren, among all the prayer intentions that we often ask you, often recommend to your prayers, there is priestly vocation. Today, on this 11th Sunday after Pentecost, we have the joy of receiving, certainly I would say, the fruit of your prayers, the fruit of your sacrifices. Throughout the year, we have the joy of having almost three and a half seminarians of our community. Brian McDermott, first of all, who has been serving here in our apostolate in Galway for several years, who is now an Abbé McDermott, who received the cassock at the end of June in our community. Dear Abbé McDermott, we would like to pray for you and assure you of tell us all our congratulations and accompany your vocation in our prayers. We also have Raphael Lacken, who is going to join our seminary in Italy in September, along with Daryl Lely, and you already all know our dear Alexis, who has been serving here for several years and who will be, who has been, whose candidacy has been accepted in our community as well. Let us always keep for good and holy vocations here in Ireland for you, for the future. The second little announcement is more material but important as well. You may remember our dear Piotr, and who passed away in March. He has been attending Mass, Holy Mass here for a good number of years, and today we would like to show our generosity and our support to his dear wife Ania and their daughter Maya. So at the end of Mass, those who would like to make a little donation to them and support this beautiful family, there will be a basket placed at the back of the church. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Dear community members and dear brethren, there is in today's Gospel a word which is kind of unusual. It's not a word in Latin, it's not a word in French, it's not in Italian, it's in Aramaic, as we can hear sometimes during Holy Week. The word effeta. Effeta is a word that comes from the tongue that our Lord Jesus Christ himself was speaking on a daily basis. And it's the word by which the man who is brought to him, to his presence, this man is healed when he hears the word effeta. Effeta means be opened. In the Gospel of St. Mark today, we indeed see, we contemplate this man who was brought to our Lord. He was deaf and dumb. That means he was unable to hear, he was unable to speak. And the reality was that for his spiritual life, he was in a certain sense unable to confess his faith. He was really cut off from hearing others and from speaking with others. It resulted a virtual isolation. And this man today heard the divine word, effeta, from our Lord's lips, from his voice. He heard Jesus' voice that touched his soul, his body, and he was healed. That means by healing we understand the way to life was opened by God. Effeta is a word not totally unknown to you, I'm sure. If you ever attended a baptism in the traditional form, you have heard this word effeta. During the baptism ceremony, the child is received in the Catholic Church and his soul is unable to receive the sanctifying grace. And on this very day, during this baptism ceremony, the priest put the salt of wisdom to the child's tongue. He touches the ears and he says, like our Lord, effeta. That means be opened. This was done to this man, to the children, so that they can hear the teaching of God, so that they can speak out wisely in order to praise him, to praise God. Sometimes, as we all experience in our life, we can be spiritually and emotionally paralyzed. Sometimes it's because of good reasons, but most of the time it's also because of our own fault, because we have neglected our spiritual life, because we have provoked sin into our lives, because we have invited sin to live and to stay close with us. And then the only solution to get rid of this paralysis, if I may call it like that, is to invite Christ. To invite Christ, our Lord himself, to whisper into our depth and to touch our ears, to touch our lips, to touch our soul and our whole body with this word, this miraculous word, this divine word, effeta, be opened. You see, in the first book of the Holy Scripture, the book of Genesis, we read about the original sin, And the original sin is the cause of Adam's and Eve's separation from God. Sin really isolates someone from the source of life, from love, and from grace. When sin is committed, we all experience that we are then locked into our own wills. We are deaf to the voice of God. We are not open to any advice. We are not docile. And we become, most of the time, self-absorbed. And the result, after one sin, is another sin. Abyssum, abyssus, abyssum invocat. One sin provokes or invites another one. And this is how sadness, fear, anger, and physical things can really be inflicted to ourselves and also to those around us. Our first inclination, then, in this state of sin, is to turn first to ourselves, to keep, first of all, our personal interest, to be ignorant of the voice of life, to be deaf to the word of God, and then, with God's grace, because God is not only just, but also merciful, He always gives us His grace, and we can always respond to Him. We can always respond to God's grace, regardless of the sins that we have committed. This is what Catholicism teaches us, and this is why Catholicism is such a beautiful religion, such a hopeful religion. It's not something that was created by a man, but Catholicism was instituted by God Himself, by our Lord Jesus Christ. And here we are hope. Here we are confident. We know that because Catholicism is divine, because the Church itself is divine, we can no longer be trapped in our own minds. With God's grace in His Church, with the availability of the sacraments, we know that there is always a way not to let our heart be hardened, not to let our spirit be paralyzed. We can always beg for God's grace. We can always tell our dear Lord how we need Him, how we need to Him to come and touch our lips, touch our ears, so that we can then be spiritually healed. And this is what we have today on this 11th Sunday after Pentecost. This is a direct command from the Lord. Our Lord has the power to release us from bondage to self and sin. Holy Mass must be an effeta moment. You see, if we feel today that prayer life is difficult, if today we have very little desire to pray, if in our lives we can feel a long time being restless and irritable, if we are ever overcome with despair, if we don't know if one day we will then have the strength to endure what will we demand of us, it's a sign that all we have to do now in our spiritual life is to kneel down and beg God's grace. Let Christ come within our soul and ask Him to touch us and to whisper into our depths again these words, "Effeta," be open. Today, let us ask God first to approach, let us ask Him the grace to kneel down, to be able to kneel down in His presence, to approach Him. One of the beautiful saints that we have meditated so many times in Italy during our priestly formation is Saint Francis of Assisi. He's of course very known. And in his life, we read these beautiful words. Once filled with sorrow for his sinfulness, Saint Francis repeated this phrase so many times, "Lord, be merciful to me, a sinner." And then we can read, gradually an indescribable joy and tremendous sweetness began to well up deep in his heart. Certainty of the forgiveness of all his sins poured in, and the assurance of being received in grace was given to him. Then his inmost soul opened wide. He clearly saw the future. As that sweetness and light withdrew, he was renewed in spirit. Dear brethren, like the man of the Gospel today, and like St. Francis of Assisi, let us wait patiently on the mercy of the Lord to touch our heart and mind. Let us beg God for an Ephata moment today that can only start in humility and sorrow for our sins, praying these words, have mercy on me, O Lord, and heal my soul, for I have sinned against thee. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Credo in unum et Deum. Romania secula seculorum. Dominus vobis. Sagamus Domino Deo Nostro. Vere dignum et justum est ecum et salutarem. Nos et tibi semper et ubique gratia saragere. Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens Aeterne Deus, qui cum unigenito Filio Tuo et Spiritus Sancto unus est Deus, unus est Dominus, non in unius singularitate personae, sed in unius Trinitate et substantiae. Quod enim de tua gloria revelant te credimus, hoc de Filio tuo, hoc de Spiritus Sanctum, sine differentia discretionis sanctimus, ut in confessione vere sempiter neque deitatis, et in personis proprietas, et in essentia unitas, et in majestate adoretur equalitas, quam laudant angelia de quia arcangeli, cherubim quoque ac seraphim, qui non cessant acclamare quotidie una voce dicente. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Oremus, percepti salutaribus monitim, et divina in institutione formati, auderemus dicere. Pater noster, qui es in celi, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentatione. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Pax Domini sit semper vobis.
Sanctus Apostolus Petro et Paolo, Omnibus Sanctus et Invitato, qui et peccati in excogitazione verbo et opere, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Video peco abbiati Mariam Semper Vecem, biasime Cherem Arcangelum, biasime Ionem Baptista, Sanctus Apostolus Petro et Paolo, Omnes Sanctus et Invitato, orare pro me ad Dominum Deum nostrum.
Miseria tua vestri omnipotens Deus, dimissis peccatis vestris, peducat vos et vitam aeternam. Indulgentiam absolutionem et remissionem peccatorum vestrorum, tribuat vobis omnipotens et misericors Dominus. Ecce agnus Dei, ecce tutollit peccata mundi. Domine nostrum dignum, qui fres spectrum meum, set omnem libero et sanctura anima mea. Domine nostrum dignum, qui fres spectrum meum, set omnem libero et sanctura anima mea. Domine nostrum dignum, qui fres spectrum meum, set omnem libero et sanctura anima mea.
Senesiamus quesumus domine tui percepcione sacramenti, subsidium mentis et corporis, ut in utroque salvati celestis remedii plenitudine gloriemur. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Oremus. Exaudi nos Deus, salutaris noster, et populum tuum viracundi et tuet erroribus liberum, et misericordiae tuae fac lagitate secum. Quesumus omnipotens Deus, ut per hac sacramenta quesum simus, intercedentibus meritis et precibus beati Joachim, pateris genitricis dilecti filii tui Domini nostri Iesu Christi, tue gratien presenti et eterne glorien futuro, participes semereamus. Per eundem Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus
benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.